Hello everyone, in this presentation I will present CougaR, a fast and Eclipse-Resilient Dissemination protocol for blockchain networks. This is a joint work with Spyros Voulgaris. Blockchains are technology for maintaining a Byzantine fault-tolerant state machine by replicating it across nodes in the peer-to-peer network. Despite their fame and evolution, a key problem blockchain systems are still facing today is scalability, a fundamental factor limiting the performance of blockchain systems is the inherent message propagation delay introduced by the peer-to-peer network. Reducing the message propagation delay can lead to higher transaction throughput as it allows one to increase the block size, to increase the block generation rate, or to employ faster consensus algorithms. Besides higher throughput, reducing the propagation delay also strengthens the security of the system by lowering the probability of forks. The design of our protocol starts with the dissemination model, that is, defining the specific interactions between nodes that allowed messages to be efficiently and reliably disseminated over the available links. To cater for fast dissemination while keeping the network overhead low, we adopt a two-step block forwarding scheme that gives the receiving node control on how many copies of the block it wants to receive. A node acquiring a new block, it immediately advertises it by forwarding its header rather than the block itself to all its neighbors, letting each of them individually decide whether it would also like to be sent the actual block on demand. This way, the receiving node can perform a validity check on the header before requesting the actual block body, diminishing the effect of denial-of-service attack that try to spread invalid blocks. Upon receiving the actual block body, a node performs a complete validity check for all transactions of the block, and provided the check succeeds, the node is ready to start forwarding it further to its own neighbors in the same way. The validation prevents malformed block propagation in the network. Given the dissemination model described, the original problem of fast block dissemination can be reduced to a link placement or neighbor selection problem for opting dissemination speed. A new block should be disseminated fast and exhaustively at a local scale, harnessing the low latency links of geographically proximate locations and ensuring that every single nearby node receives the block through a fast, low latency local path. In addition, a dissemination algorithm should also encompass a global outlook, managing to spread the news fast to distant locations. In our proposed protocol, we form links based on metrics that cannot be faked. Namely, each node establishes links to a number of other nodes out of the following two sets. The set of close neighbors. These are nodes exhibiting low network latency to each other. And the set of random neighbors. These are neighbors picked uniformly at random out of all participating nodes. The rationale behind this decision is that our protocol does not demand a multiple of nodes at each distant region, but rather just a few sporadic representatives. Note that explicitly selecting distant rather than random nodes involves security risks, as being a distant node can easily be emulated by simply delaying all communications. Malicious nodes could easily take advantage of this to attract leaks from the entire network, something we want to prevent at all costs. In contrast, the property of being close to a given node cannot be faked. So we propose an adaptive decentralized protocol named CougaR, in which each node establishes C++ links to nodes of its choice and measures their latencies by a number of ping messages, periodically and now discards its r most distant neighbors, replacing them by r randomly picked ones. In effect, at any given time, a node maintains links to C nodes of the close neighbor set and R nodes of the random neighbor set. The periodic rejuvenation of node's neighbor set helps it adapt to dynamic conditions, replacing non-responsive or distant nodes by randomly picked ones and to maintain links to nearby neighbors of low network latency. Now, let's discuss about related work to see the novelty of our protocol and compare against the state of the art. The random connection algorithm, in which each node establishes a number of connections to a random set of peers. The geographic is a simple heuristic to take geographic location of nodes into account, assuming this can be inferred through their IP addresses. According to this heuristic, we make each node to pick half of its neighbors randomly among peers from the same continent and the other half randomly among peers from different continents. The structure approach proposes a broadcast protocol based on the contemporary DHT. And finally, the score-based approach by a protocol named Perigee, which proposes a scoring function to assess every neighbor based on its ability to deliver blocks and retains the best subset of neighbors at regular intervals. Now, let's compare these approaches with a figure that shows the progress of dissemination in the course of time elapsed since the block's generation by indicating for each point in time the percentage of mining power that have not yet received and validated the respective block. The upper part of the figure reports the case of no transfer failures, while the lower part reports the results when 10% of blocks transfers fail. As expected, random connectivity performs the worst in both cases. Kademlia and Geographic shared the third and fourth positions, with Kademlia having an edge when failures occur due to its structured topology. Perigee comes closer to CougaR, mostly in the absence of failures. When block transfers exhibit random failures, CougaR clearly outperforms Perigee. This is due to Perigee's scoring function being sensitive to transfer failures in the presence of which it proposes suboptimal nodes as neighbors. An interesting fact that is clearly illustrated in the figure is the difference between CougaR and Geographic. One could wrongly assume that picking random long-distant and random short-distant links, that is, the geographic heuristic, should be practically equivalent to CougaR's selection of close and random links. This is strongly disproven by the performance comparison. The difference lies in the fact that it's not the geographic distance but latency-wise proximity that CougaR takes into account for link placement. Likewise, picking random peers is not equivalent to picking explicitly distant peers either. So, to categorize the solutions we just saw based their ingredients and to compare them, the random connectivity algorithm provides us the worst time. However, we consider it as eclipse-resistant under two assumptions that we make for all these five algorithms we see in this table. First, the underlying peer sampling service can provide nodes with a truly unbiased random set of peers. And second, we assume the presence of an effective defense mechanism against Sybil attacks so that a physical node cannot acquire an unlimited number of identities. Geographically close and distant provides us moderate time. However, this algorithm has practical difficulties. First, since many nodes connect through a Tor network, IP addresses cannot be known. Second, with the help of VPNs or proxies, one may present an IP address in an arbitrary geographic region. As such, link selection algorithm is prone to manipulation. It cannot be considered eclipse-resistant. A structure overlay like the one with the Kademlia DHT we saw provides us also with moderate speed. However, we consider such a structure overlay as eclipse-resistant under two additional conditions. First, each node has an unfortunate DHT identifier. And second, the overlay has a mechanism to locate the alive node whose ID is closest to the desired point in the ID space. The score-based paradigm, like the one we saw on Perigee, we are not sure if we can call it fast or moderate with respect to the dissemination time, since, as we saw, it is still questionable how such a protocol can handle a moderate percentage of block transfer failures that can confuse the scoring mechanism, making it pick in essence peers at random. A pitfall of such a protocol is its defense against Eclipse attacks, as an adversary could easily dominate a victim's connections by providing well-connected peers. A well-known way of performing this attack is by an attacker skipping the block validation process in order to be the first to deliver new blocks to the victim and acquire a top score in its rankings. So, such protocol cannot be considered eclipse-resistant. And finally, CougaR, that provides us fast and eclipse-resistant dissemination, since low network latency is a property that cannot be forged if the attacker is not for real in the network proximity to the victim. We consider CougaR to be the winner as it combines the fastest relaying of blocks with the highest security against Eclipse attacks, outperforming other protocols' trade-off between speed and security in both these dimensions. To conclude, CougaR is a protocol simple to deploy. It provides fast and eclipse-resistant dissemination of blocks in blockchain networks. It is bandwidth efficient since each node requests the block body from its neighbors, so no block be sent unsolicited, flooding the network. It converges asynchronously with respect to block dissemination, as latency measurements between nodes are independent of block propagation. And it's adaptive, as by periodically measuring latencies to neighboring nodes, it adapts to any network or node failures.